There are many questions from you about the hemogram test, friends. I will briefly explain how this test is interpreted and what it means, in a way that you can understand. Now look, there is a hemogram test here. Let's interpret the results together. In a nutshell, WBC, i.e. leukocyte, these are the cells that fight germs in our body. The rise of this is normal in this report. It is usually a sign of infection. There may be bacterial and viral infection. Apart from that, it increases in many cases such as allergies, autoimmune diseases, pregnancy, fever, burns, stress. But it is usually a sign of infection. Low WBC is not seen very often, but it may decrease in bone marrow diseases. It may decrease in some drugs used outside of it, may decrease in HIV infection, may decrease in autoimmune diseases, liver and spleen diseases, spleen enlargement may decrease, and may decrease in very severe infections. But like I said, it's not seen very often. We learned that leukocytes are cells in our body that fight microbes. Yes, what does RBC mean? RBC means red blood cell in English, that is, red blood cells. These are our cells that carry oxygen to the tissues. If this is high, it means erythrocytosis, which can also indicate a disease with excess red blood cell production in the bone marrow, usually due to genetic reasons. Apart from that, congestive heart failure, that is, problems in heart work, COPD, fibrosis in the lung, kidney diseases, some tumors of the kidney with some drugs used, or those living at high altitudes and living in mountain villages may also increase the RBC level. So what does it mean to have a low RBC? If it is low, it means you may have anemia. The causes of anemia are many. There may be iron deficiency, folic acid, B12 deficiency, there may be bone marrow failure. There are some autoimmune diseases called intravascular hemolysis. It may be due to them or it may be due to chronic diseases. Intestinal diseases such as chronic kidney diseases, autoimmune diseases, some infections, HIV and tuberculosis and some cancers, leukemia, multiple myeloma, ulcerative colitis, Crohn's can also lower your RBC level and lead to anemia. Yes, what is HGB, friends? It means hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a protein found in the RBC I just described. This is a protein responsible for carrying oxygen to the tissues. HGB rises for the same reasons as RBC, and decreases for the same reasons. Look, this patient has 9.8, that is, he has anemia. Of course, his doctor will investigate the reason for this. One of the reasons I have mentioned will come out. HCT stands for hematocrit. What does that mean? It is the ratio of the red blood cell in the blood to the whole blood. This, of course, usually goes up and down for reasons like RBC. For example, what are the main reasons for its fall? The level decreases in cases such as bone marrow diseases, chronic inflammatory diseases, iron deficiency, folate deficiency, B12 deficiency, hemorrhages, hemolytic anemia in which women are disintegrated, kidney failure, leukemia. Elevated hematocrit levels are rare, which may result in congestive heart failures, congenital heart diseases, dehydration, kidney tumor, lung diseases, or polycythemia vera, a genetically overproduced disease. But hemoglobin, erythrocyte count, hematocrit, they usually rise and fall together. Their low level generally indicates anemia. MCV means mean corpuscular volume, which indicates the mean diameter of these erythrocytes. A high MCV means the diameter of your erythrocytes is larger than normal, but there is still anemia. What are the reasons for this? It can be B12 deficiency, folic acid deficiency or chemotherapy, spleen and liver disease. Low MCV means that your erythrocytes are small in diameter. Low MCV is also usually seen in anemia due to iron deficiency anemia, thalassemia, lead poisoning or chronic diseases. MCH means, it stands for mean corpuscular volume, which indicates the average weight of hemoglobin per erythrocyte. What does MCH height mean? This usually indicates that you have a spherocytosis, a genetic condition, sickle cell anemia, or some homozygous disease, such as hemoglobin C disease. In other words, it indicates situations where hemoglobin level is high in erythrocytes. A low MCH level indicates that your hemoglobin level is actually low. The main reasons for this are iron deficiency anemia, some chronic diseases, related anemia, thalassemia, and lead poisoning. MCHC means mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, which means the mean erythrocyte hemoglobin concentration. This gives roughly the weight of hemoglobin in a given amount of erythrocytes. Well, what does MCHC height mean? This increases in some conditions just like MCH. While it is high in hereditary spherocytosis, sickle cell anemia, or hemoglobin C disease, low levels indicate the causes of anemia. It is especially low in iron deficiency anemia, anemia due to some chronic diseases, thalassemia, and lead poisoning anemia. PLT means platelet. Platelets are the cells that go there first and form a plug when there is a bleeding or an incision in our body. Therefore, low PLT level may result in bleeding risk. Why do platelets, PLT, decrease? In bone marrow diseases, aplastic anemia, some bone marrow cancers, B12 or folic acid deficiency, long-term alcohol consumption, blood poisoning, blood transfusions, some chronic diseases, receiving chemotherapy, receiving radiotherapy, viral infections, pregnancy, and especially some autoimmune diseases falls. For example, low PLT is common in ITP, TTP. High platelet count can occur for many reasons. We consider over 450,000 to be high. Platelet elevation is seen mainly in iron deficiency anemia. Disease or loss of function of the spleen, some bone marrow tumors, rheumatic diseases, some drugs used, disintegration of erythrocytes in the vein, that is, diseases that go with hemolysis, and some inflammatory bowel diseases may increase. Too many platelet elevations, for example values of 700,000 and above, can often suggest a bone marrow tumor. LYM or lymphocyte, look, it has given its percent here. Lymphocyte is one of these leukocytes, a cell type that protects our body against infections. A high LYM, both percentage and number, usually indicates an overproduction situation. This is usually chickenpox, flu, tuberculosis, mumps, rubella, CMV, brucellosis, herpes simplex, or a side effect of some drugs, or some viral diseases such as infectious mononucleosis. Apart from that, it may be due to conditions such as hepatitis, AIDS, autoimmune diseases after blood transfusions. Low lymphocyte, that is, low rate or number, is usually a number of infectious diseases, influenza, hepatitis, autoimmune diseases, steroid drug therapy, radiotherapy, blood diseases, some genetic diseases, DeGeorge syndrome, Wiskott-Aldrich syndrome, ataxia telangiectasia. These are genetic diseases. LYM level may decrease in cases such as insufficiency of the immune system. Monocyte, i.e. mono, is also one of the leukocytes types. It constitutes about 8 to 10% of the leukocytes in the blood. What this does is, it helps us in the fight against viral, bacterial, and fungal infections. So why do monocytes rise? It generally increases in bacterial infections, fungal infections, parasitic infections, heart diseases, rheumatism diseases, lung diseases, tuberculosis, autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis, irritable bowel syndrome or overweight or leukemia, lymphoma. A low monocyte may indicate an immune deficiency. Monocyte levels may decrease in cases such as autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, newly started viral infections, excessive stress, B12 deficiency, tuberculosis, and leukemia. What does the percentage of neutrophils mean? Neutrophil is a type of leukocyte just like monocytes. This is the most abundant leukocytes in the blood. Approximately 55 to 170% of leukocytes are made up of neutrophils. What does that do again? It is an immune cell that tries to protect us from viruses, bacteria, and fungi. So what does high neutrophil mean? Just like monocytes and lymphocytes, it brings to mind the possibility of an infection. What are some viral infections, bacterial infections, trauma to the body, surgery, excessive smoking, stress, excessive exercise, steroid drug use, having a heart attack, or in some leukemia cases, your neutrophil level may increase. So what does neutrophil drop mean? This shows that the immunity is weakened. Taking chemotherapy drugs, some drugs, bone marrow failures, extreme anemia, some conditions we call febrile neutropenia. These increase the risk of infection a lot. Some congenital disorders of the bone marrow, viruses such as hepatitis A, B, C, HIV virus, sepsis. In cases such as blood poisoning, autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis, leukemias, myelodysplastic syndromes of the bone marrow, the level of neutrophils, that is, our immunity, may decrease. Basophil is also a type of leukocytes, but the proportion of basophils is low, making up less than 1%. This also helps us to fight against infectious agents such as viruses, bacteria, fungi. Why is basophilic elevation seen? It usually indicates some inflammatory conditions, but the feature of this is that it can sometimes indicate serious problems such as cancer or immune system problems. For example, basophils may be thrown in basophilic leukemia, in myeloproliferative diseases of the bone marrow. Our basophil level may increase in Hodgkin's disease, hypothyroidism, a kind of goiter, diabetes, and spleen removal or intestinal inflammation. So why is low basophil seen? Generally, acute rheumatic fever, pneumonia, steroid therapy, thyrotoxicosis, which we call thyroid gland overwork or excessive stress may decrease, but low basophilia does not have much diagnostic significance. In addition to the percentage of C in my hemogram report, there's an asterisk on the side like this and the symbol of the same cells again. See here star next to lymphocyte, monocyte, neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil. An asterisk indicates the absolute number of these cells, not the percentage. It was the percentage I just counted, which means almost the same thing as the number, that is, the percentage. The reasons that increase and decrease them are the same as the situations I mentioned above. RDW means red cell distribution width, an indication of the difference between these erythrocytes. So having a high RDW means that the erythrocytes are quite different from each other throughout. This may be an iron deficiency, B12 deficiency, folic acid deficiency anemia, or in chronic kidney failure. It doesn't matter if the RDW is low. This RDW test is generally used in the differential diagnosis of iron deficiency anemia and thalassemia. RDW is normal in thalassemia. It is high in iron deficiency anemia. It is not used much. What is PDW? A test that shows the difference in size of platelets. That is, if the PDW is high, the platelets are different from each other in size. This test is not very important if the platelet count is normal. It is evaluated together with the platelet count. High PDW may be high in some cancers. Cancers such as multiple myeloma, lymphoma, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, and pulmonary embolism. Leukemia, chemotherapy, radiotherapy, or a type of anemia called aplastic anemia may be low. But as I said, if the platelet count is normal, it is not a very important test. MPV stands for mean platelet volume, meaning that a high platelet indicates a larger diameter of the platelets. This is not a very important test if the platelet count is normal. Why is MPV elevation seen? It can be seen in some cancers, hyperthyroidism, overwork of the thyroid gland, heart diseases, diabetes, vitamin D deficiency, hypertension, and heart rhythm disorder. MPV level may increase. When does the MPV value decrease? It decreases in some intestinal diseases such as ulcerative colitis and Crohn's. Taking chemotherapy and anemia called aplastic anemia, the MPV level may decrease. But as I said, this test is not a very important test if the platelet count is normal. And what is our final test, PCT? PCT shows the platelectric bundle, that is, the volume occupied by the platelets, as a percentage of the platelets in the blood. In other words, it means the ratio of platelets to blood, kind of like HCT in erythrocytes. The platelet count is also calculated with the formula XMPV/10,000. If the platelet count is normal, it doesn't matter much, but elevated PCT levels are typical especially in ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease, which are intestinal diseases, and in these diseases, PCT elevation can help with diagnosis. Yes, we have learned the hemogram test simply. Now let's look at this patient. See here, hemoglobin, hematocrit, MCV, MCH, MCHC levels are low. So this patient has anemia. There is a microcytic anemia of erythrocytes small in diameter because MCV is low. Look, RDW is high. This is usually seen in iron deficiency anemia. So these patients most likely have iron deficiency anemia. Yes, see you in the next video. Bye, friends. We say that's enough for the hemogram test.